Hello, ladies and gentlemen, Captain Shack here, and welcome back to Space Engineers. We're talking about a mod spotlight here, a build spotlight, actually, for the Halo universe. I'm inside a UNSC Pelican dropship, and it's amazing. So let me go ahead and close the bay door up here. We're going to get landed. Our objective today is, one, check out some awesome builds by PrimoSuperT over on the workshop, and to try to load up a Pelican with a Warthog on the back and take it over to the Fallen City. So let me just squeeze in here. I love what he's done with the LCDs. That's actually really cool for the gunner's seats for the twin guns. There we go. You did see there was the seat behind me, so he does have the dual seats. All right, this is Hammer. I'm ready to, I don't have control. I don't have control yet. Let's see, landing gear triggers. They have remote triggers on here? He does not have remote triggers. I have not actually flown this yet, so we're kind of jumping in blind. Oh no, she's flying. She's just gyro-wise really sluggish. So sluggish, in fact, that I didn't think I had control. Woo, but look at this build. Let me spin it around so we can get it in the sun. We got two different versions of Warthog on the deck right now. We've got the machine gun mounted back one, and then we've got the traditional just troop transport. Oh my God, this looks good. Now it's mostly vanilla blocks. The only thing that he's got in here is a little bit of an outdated Windows mod, but it does look pretty fantastic. That's why we've got the small block windows. It's even giving me bearings. So I'm right now pointing southwest by, that's cool. Now we're pointing west. Very nice, very nice. All right, let me go ahead. This is my test map, by the way, so if you see a couple of random things, like potentially a droid dropship in the sky, there it is. Oh, if you see a loser Hulk in the sky, don't mind that. Don't mind that. I've been testing a bunch of builds over here. So anyways, we've got our landing arms. Now, we've got landing gear, we've got some controls here. Let's try, seeing what we've got for controls and see what we can pick up. So our rear door, you saw me lift that up. So that's a rotor door. We've got advanced rotor wings. We've got movable wings on this? What? Oh, weird, okay. We're gonna turn that back on for locking. The wings moved on the Pelicans? I don't remember that. It's been a while since I played Halo. The last one I played was, the one with Nathan Fillion as a main character, and I can't remember the name of it now. Let's see. We've got timer block trigger now for landing gear. So our landing gear, look, they're already down. Let's see if we can bring them up. Landing gear are up. Nice. Now that back section is... No, it's landing gear back there, and they're unlocked. So let's see if we can get in position. We're already starting to slowly make our way over it. Let's see if we can pull in. One of my favorite memories playing co-op, the original Halo Combat Evolved, was when you get that first Warthog. And you realize like how big the world space is. God, that game was good for co-op. All right, bringing it in. Playing on Legendary. Oh, so good. We're gonna take the non-machine gun. No, we're gonna take the machine gun version. All right, come over to the port side. That's why it's flying so sluggish. It's because of those rotors. It's gotta be because of the rotors. When you do the multiple grids thing, it really throws off the flight characteristics of whatever it is you're flying. She seems to fly okay. It still feels like you'd imagine a Pelican would be as a troop transport or a vehicle transport. All right, let's bring it in a little bit more. No, I need to be able to see. Bring down a little bit more. All right, fine. We'll do spectator camera so I can see what the juice is going on here. There's a camera. There's a camera, Shaq. There was a camera the whole time. All right. So let's do a little bit more starboard, 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 up, up, up. It is super early in the morning right now. I am getting ready for a trip to LA, so I will be gone for the next few days. So content on the channel is gonna be a little light. Here we go. Now, nailed it. Go. Oh God, I got it. We're good, we're fine, everything's fine. Oh my God, that's cool. We just picked up a Warthog with a Pelican and we're flying. Now there is a, there's the Fallen City. We're gonna head in that direction. So there is it's a mod that you can download that actually gives you the ring structure, right? So the Halo ring. It's cool because, I'll put a link in the description. I don't have it, I used to have it in this map, but I actually pulled it out. It's been converted into voxels. So it doesn't completely lag out your game when it spawns in, though it doesn't have gravity like you'd imagine, so you're not going to be walking around the inside of the ring. I don't believe it does. The blocked version that did lag the game to complete hell did have gravity, because it had gravity generators built into the structure. Okay, there's the city there. Now you just have your buddies loaded up in the truck. Yeah, when I get back from my trip, we're gonna have to get some multiplayer going on Twitch and see if we can get some UNSC versus like the colonies action going on. Maybe make a couple of maps. I think that'd be a lot of fun. Ooh, Space Engineer Defense Kit would work perfectly. You get make a pelican in there. They got to drop in, maybe complete some kind of objective. Throw in a couple of warthogs. Yeah, I could see this. All right, there's the city. Let's find a good drop zone. I'm thinking far side, on the side of that tower right over there. So we'll go ahead and swing it around. We'll drop our ride, and then we'll get out of this vehicle and get into it. Because I don't have an actual squad of Marines with me ready to kick ass and take names against the Covenant. Let's see. At this point in the war, the UNSC wouldn't be able to win a single space battle. Maybe one. I think Keys won one battle. If this was like the heart of the war. Let's go ahead and bring it down. Now remember, I haven't played any of the newer Halo games, so I figure, you know what, let's spot this after everybody's talking about the new Halo announcement. New Halo coming out, and a new Gears of War coming out, and weirdly enough, like an XCOM Gears of War is on the way. That just blows me away. All right, bringing it down, gonna hit 9. Watch those shocks, don't explode, baby. That was actually a really high drop. Now, she flipped over, and I was kinda hoping this would happen because there is an option on that ride. Let's go ahead and... So that was sorta on purpose. Bring the gear down. There they are. I already lowered the ramp. Now, these are really spindly gears. I love theme builds, because they're never built for like, they're gonna work great in Space Engineers. You know, let's actually shut her down and see if the gear can hold the weight of this thing. So we're gonna shut down. We're sorta gonna shut down. I killed the power, but yet she's still got power. Shut down. Okay, hydros. Hydros off. Holy crap. Holy crap. They actually work. I was sure they were gonna snap in half, but they didn't do it. All right, let's walk down. Oh, this ramp is good. And we just power down. So she's fully sitting on these legs. These spindly little legs. Huh. I like that he's used the sound block to look like it's got a hinge right there. Oh, that's really cool. I mean, it does have a rotor on the other side, but I just like a little bit of detail. Very nice, very nice. All right, let's see if this works. So in the control panel for the Warthog, there is a press X to flip option. Now, that's, you know, a callback to, well, Halo, where you could go up to the rides and Master Chief with his super strength could grab the thing and flip it over, or over and over. Okay, so there it is, press X to flip. Oh, are you just a gyro? Press X to flip. Okay, start. It moved a little bit. Let me get remote control from the driver's seat. It's a driver's seat, control. Wait, what is that noise? Is it doing it with pistons? No, it was a tire block, so it could be doing anything. I didn't see it do anything. I was kind of hoping it would like flip up. All right, let's go. Remote control, driver, control it, and let us press X to flip. So now press X to flip, and trigger now. It moves. It like jostles just a little bit, but doesn't seem like enough. All right, come on, baby. Come on, baby. Something's going to explode. Well, okay, we'll reset it with commands. I was really hoping. Oh man, look at the detail on the bottom. That's where I always fail with my build. Like the detail on the bottom of whatever the vehicles I'm building, I just kind of ignore it. Not the best. All right, let's get into the city. We've got a mission objective here. So he uses passenger seats for all of the seats. So we're gonna have to go in and use the control driver seat. Go in control. Dun, 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 dun. Dun, dun, dun. Let's go third person. Now this variant does have the back mounted gun. We can go ahead and take control of that. Let's see, that was with turret lock is 3. There we go. Turret lock off, so we can take control of it and move it around. I look like I broke it. Looks like I may have broken it. Or I didn't break it. I know what I did. It was already unlocked. Potentially. Control. There we go. Full rotation. There we go. We have control of the turret. So there it is. He has the mount where you can like get a guard, or I almost said a guardsman, a marine behind it to grab onto it to fire away. Looks like a piece of it may have broken off. But there's no way to actually get back there and grab it. So you'd have your buddy who's sitting here next to you in the seat to run the main turret. It does have a targeter if you've never used it, a turret on the back of a ground vehicle like this. So you can control both of these. One of the best patches for Space Engineers was when they added the, we're going into the city, was when they added the ability to control the turret and drive the vehicle at the same time. She handles, even with the oh god, isn't that crash it? She handles even with the turret on the back, the rotor running on the back, perfectly. Like, it is so good. He's got the suspension pretty dialed down, so you don't feel like you're flying all over the place. This is a wrecked city, by the way. I'll put a link in the description for what city this is. You can check it out, paste it into your world, on this desert world. Let's go ahead and go around this and give a weapons test real quick. There she goes. Now, currently in Space Engineers, there are a ton of amazing Halo builds. From the Halo rings to, like you're seeing here, the Warthog, the Pelican, a few of the other like ground vehicles, even the Walker thing that they added in one of the games that I didn't play, are in here. And he's even got a dropship. I saw one of the other Space Engineer YouTubers spotlighting it earlier this week. I was like, oh man, they've even got the dropship. So we could have a multiplayer. I'm probably gonna do this over on Twitch and then bring a video of it over onto the YouTube channel when I get back. We could do a multiplayer battle with the Covenant dropship. So that's how one group gets in. Maybe give them some energy weapons, something that has like those blue blasts. And then, all right, let's try to drive over this. We could give the UNSC, the Marines, Warthogs and a couple of Pelicans, right? And just have a blast fighting it out. Maybe even a city like this. This is probably a little bit too much for multiplayer. This may have to be something that we wait for. Whoa! Threading the needle here between these two cities, these two buildings, for the multiplayer patch that's on the way, coming out. So let's get outside the city so we can get some speed. Just driving over that. It didn't catch me. Nice. Just gonna pop some holes into your buildings. It's freaking awesome. Oh, I love it. This came out so well. So much. So this is why we can't have nice things. I'm the reason we can't have nice things, let's be honest. All right, guys, there's just a quick spotlight. I am heading out to LA tomorrow. There's a droid command ship in orbit. I'm heading out to LA tomorrow, so I'll be gone for a few days. But if you enjoyed the video, hit the subscription button. Subscribe for more sci-fi gaming and modding goodness. I will have the audio straightened out here in the office momentarily. I'll have the audio here in the office fixed up for the next big spotlights and recordings. Awakening of the Rebellion and all the normal series are on the way. So, all right, guys, I'll see you in the next one. Later, everybody.